if Bruce had come into the factory one morning and said, OK, men, we're not going to work on racing cars today, we're going to march across the Sahara Desert. We'd have all said, oh, OK, Bruce, no problem.
Motor racing is not something you just suddenly learn out of the blue. You've got to have it inside, and Bruce certainly had all that.
The McLaren was the class of the field. I wanted to learn as much as I could because Bruce was an artist.
We dreamed about doing something on our own. We didn't know how long it would take, but we've done it. He was now the youngest driver ever to win a Grand Prix.
He said it the right way around. Put your money and your effort into your race team, and then when it's really winning, you can live off the high life.
He had the ability to think big.
Bruce was always one of us.
He worked along with us.
I was in good hands with Bruce.
What he started with the McLaren team was tremendous.
McLaren went from success to success.
Bruce was a superstar. He's a jet set person.
We were testing there and he was climbing from one car into the other.
All of a sudden, it's just... and a silence.
I wanted the boys to carry on, and I wrote a letter to the team. The boys, as I always called them. My boys.
These guys were the Spitfire pilots of the 50s and 60s.
We all spoke his language, and we were all totally dedicated to him.
The legacy of Bruce McLaren lives on.